Hey friends, this video will give you tools to help you achieve the mindset and behaviors of a highly actualized and successful person. Why is this important? Well, imagine, if you will, a highly sophisticated computer. Heck, even imagine the most simple modern laptop computer. This or any other computer is an expensive paperweight without a highly sophisticated and reliable what? A highly robust, reliable operating system. All of the individual task software modules that the computer employs, such as Microsoft Word or Excel, are useless without a robust, reliable operating system. A computer, for all of its power and potential, is useless without the Windows, Linux, or iOS operating system. Or imagine trying to install the latest version of Excel on an old computer with DOS as its only operating system. Heck, you wouldn't be able to install Excel, much less use it. Well, we humans are much like this computer. We need a sophisticated, robust, and reliable operating system if we're going to live, perform, and succeed at peak levels. The problem is, virtually everyone possesses an operating system that evolved over their first 7 to 20 years through outside influence and interference, and with little, if any, purposeful awareness or designing on our part. This video covers 2 key components of our human operating system, our virtues and our values. Virtues are those qualities we have and aspire to that are near universally agreed to be special, desirable, admirable, and positive. They facilitate being a higher being, behaving and performing as a highly evolved person. A few examples of virtues, and there are many virtues, but a few are honesty, integrity, friendliness, industriousness. Again, virtues are human qualities we aspire to that are pretty much universally viewed as positive and admirable. Values, on the other hand, are just that. Values are what we value in life. We can, and pretty much all do, value virtues. Most everyone values virtues such as honesty, tenacity, passion, friendliness. But we also value other things such as sunrises, coffee, or walks in the park. Our highest values, such as the value of commitment to personal development, to success, motivation, habitually felt and acted upon, are also virtues and significant drivers of our behaviors and actions. To get the most from and for ourselves, our virtues and values matter and must be identified and managed. After all, we want and need a sophisticated, robust, and reliable operating system if we're to live, perform, and succeed at peak levels, right? There are at least 18 virtues and values that highly actualized and successful people aspire to and typically exhibit to a significant degree. These are specific human traits that are almost universally deemed admirable, desirable, and practically positive. Most of them we find in virtually any person that we would consider highly successful and actualized. These virtues and values are resourceful and productive. They're admirable and qualitatively positive. Most of them are arguably prerequisites to considerable success and personal actualization. You'll see how as we go through them. Typically, we are all inherently strong in a few virtues, but weaker perhaps, and maybe extremely weak in some of the other virtues. And again, there are many virtues. For example, one person might be inherently and particularly honest, whereas another person might be naturally very tenacious in pursuing their passions and their goals. And yet another person might naturally be very present or mindful with themselves, other people, and life in general. Yet any of these people might be considerably weaker in any number of other virtues. Now, certainly few, if any, highly actualized people will absolutely personify or adhere to all virtues and values. But having this as a goal might be good, so long as we remain self-empathetic, self-compassionate, and patient, and otherwise understanding, loving, and supportive with ourselves, and maintain an extremely high level of self-confidence. because self-confidence is crucial to considerable success. Highly successful people, including life's most happy and fulfilled people, understand that who we are by nature or God is only the rough draft. We have free will, and only through consistent and focused exercise of free will might we grow and actualize our individual potential or purpose in life and achieve our great destiny. Through self-awareness, self-education, and personal change, we might sculpt ourselves into our greatest potential actualization, fulfillment, and success. There are a few sayings you'll often hear me repeat, though not too often in this video. They're simple but profound sayings and make very important points. First quote is, "What got you to where you are today will not get you to where you want to be tomorrow." We need new beliefs, emotional states, behaviors, actions, skills, and habits. This means we must constantly learn and grow. Okay, the second quote is Einstein's definition of insanity. Do you recall what that is? The definition of insanity, per Einstein, is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. We must constantly learn and grow and change, improve upon our beliefs, our behaviors, our skills, our habits, and our habitual actions. Otherwise, we're insane because we all want more, but believing and going about it in the same way with the same habits, the same skills, is insanity. All right, the third important quote. To get something you've never had, you must do something you've never done. I will add to that. Not only must we do something we've never done, we must do these things constantly. And we must also be someone we've never been in our beliefs, our habitual thoughts and feelings, our states. And we must be and do at high and consistent levels. Sounds like a lot of work, eh? I wish living a great and fulfilling life were easy, but it's not. So let me hit you with another great quote that makes this point. It's the people who do the difficult things that have an easy life, and the people that do the easy things that have a difficult life. As you go through the virtues and values in this video, please relate them candidly and honestly to yourself. Don't listen to them as mere theoretical ideas. Rather, actively ask yourself, when, how, and why does this honestly describe me? How can I own and personify this virtue, value, or standard? I'll also ask you, when, how, and why do I fall short or even maybe violate this? How can I learn from that choice? What other choice might I make? And what will this cost me and my loved ones if I don't make it? What can I do from here on out to be sure that I live up to this virtue or this value? Look, principle and theory is useless unless we habitually apply it to ourselves and our lives and apply it at high and consistent levels. All right, so what are the 18 virtues and values that the most successful actualized people exhibit and aspire to? Virtue 1. Successful people believe there is no failure but in failing to begin or failing to continue. Have you ever gotten a result you didn't want? Of course, we all get results we don't want all the time. Have you ever not gotten enough sleep one night? Have you ever not gotten enough sleep many nights? And did you give up on the sleeping thing altogether because you clearly aren't cut out for this sleeping thing? No. Virtue number 2, insatiable thirst for growth and exceptionalism. Life's big winners win in large part because they have an insatiable thirst for growth. This drives leads them to constant self-improvement, to improving their skills, their thoughts, their habits, and their results. Leads to constant pursuit of exceptionalism, which is necessary to considerable success. Don't confuse, though, excellence with perfection. This is a trap many people fall into. Many people believe they aren't good enough, or at least not yet good enough. Therefore, they put their dreams and their potential on hold. They outright sabotage their efforts and results. There is no such thing as perfection, or another way to look at at it is we are all already perfect as we are. This is really important because it might be the number one thing that holds most people back, either greatly slowing their development of their greatest gifts, their contribution and success, or preventing it. Just do it. Learn as you go along, adjust, and keep doing it. You probably won't be as bad as you fear you are at first. And given optimism bias, which you'll see in other videos, you're not going to be as good as you think you are as you get better. Just do it. Remain self-aware, committed to constant improvement, and evolve. Okay, the next virtue is optimism. The supercharged expectation. Thousands of studies of optimism and pessimism have proven that optimists perform better, they succeed at higher rates, they are healthier, and there is some evidence that they live longer. If you want to be a peak performer, if you want to succeed to your greatest potential, then be or become an optimist. You get to choose your beliefs. Choose to believe you have positive personal power to affect everything for the better in your life. Okay, the next virtue, enthusiasm. Optimism on steroids. Enthusiasm, as I use it here, is taking optimism to the next level, accentuating it, heightening it, a passionate, purposeful drive with absolute certainty. Highly successful people aren't only optimistic, they're passionately optimistic about their mission in life, certain of their ability to achieve their mission. Any great thing that any human being has ever purposefully accomplished has been driven by passion, enthusiasm, heightened optimism, certainty that they can and will succeed. Exceptional results take time. They require considerable creativity, industriousness, and a sense of purpose. Without the passion of enthusiasm, our will and actions will almost certainly lack the sustained focus, will, and intense energy necessary to achieve great things. What's more, without passion, the passion of enthusiasm, we may falter, stumble, or quit upon meeting the inevitable obstacles we will meet. With enthusiasm, we storm through, over, or around these obstacles. The next virtue, mission or purpose, knowing and owning your why in life. Our beliefs drive all of our behaviors and actions. Ask yourself, what do I do and why do I do it? Drill past your first and obvious answers. Our first answers to questions of beliefs often have been programmed into us by media, society, family, peer groups, or simply lazy habit on our part. You may currently believe it, but again, because it may not serve you and those around you. So evaluate yourself, ask yourself, what are my whys? What drives me? And why do I think and feel and do as I do? And is it serving me? Is it the highest, best choice that I should be making? Remember, no great thing has ever been purposefully accomplished by any human being without great passion, otherwise known as enthusiasm. Your why is your passion, your meaning, your purpose. Okay, the next virtue, self-confidence. Self-confidence is important to success. Successful people are typically very self-confident. They're typically overconfident. This allows them to develop or maintain an appetite for risk. Risk is a crucial component of accomplishing significant things. There's a cautionary downside to self-confidence. Studies of highly successful people typically show that they overestimate their contribution to organizations and underestimate others' contributions. Studies also show that highly successful entrepreneurs either never doubted themselves in their mission, or they habitually minimized or destroyed any doubts that entered their minds. Believe in yourself and your mission. Tenaciously, passionately believe. Never give in to doubt or pessimism. Destroy them. Vaporize them. However, if you have a team or organization around you, be aware that you might unrealistically minimize others' contribution and overestimate yours. Believe in yourself, yes. Also believe in and support your team. Next virtue is gratitude and celebration. Without gratitude, there is arguably some lack of recognition and acknowledgement of accomplishment and success. If we don't recognize and acknowledge ourselves and our accomplishments and others and their accomplishments and good fortune, we miss out on a powerful motivator and incentive, while also our greatest fortune in getting what we have wanted. In any event, isn't the whole point in life to enjoy it, to experience consistent joy, pleasure, and fulfillment? To experience the good things in life, such as success. The wise, successful, actualized person allows themselves to recognize, feel, and experience gratitude and celebrate little and big wins. It motivates and inspires us, allows us to enjoy life more, and it also attracts others to us. It makes us more magnetic to other people. And we need people for relationships, both personal and professional. Now think about it. Aren't you attracted to people who are grateful, who are positive, especially if their gratitude is extended towards you? And aren't people who celebrate much more fun to be around? Their mentality and behavior is one of joy, positivity, and appreciation. Gratitude and celebration within and directed towards others are important to success and fulfillment. The next virtue. Highly actualized, successful people choose and empower meanings regarding life's events and circumstances. They understand that they cannot and do not control the world, much as we all try to. Things happen. Most events and circumstances remain relatively outside of our control. Highly successful and actualized people inherently or purposefully perceive or interpret life's events in a way that empowers and emboldens them. They don't allow events or circumstances to diminish them, their passion, or their determination. They seek and find empowering interpretations and feelings about life's circumstances. It's not always easy, guys. You know that. But we always get to decide what things mean to us, how we're going to be affected by things. We're going to let life's crucibles forge the metal of our emphatic determination to win, to succeed, to matter, to be great. Or will we define things that diminish us, harm us? Highly actualized and successful people don't allow bad luck, ill fortune, or screw-ups to get them down. Okay, the next virtue. Things must change, and only I can change them. This is true of highly successful people on at least two levels. First of all, this relates to their passion for personal excellence, their passion to constantly learn and improve that I talked about earlier. They're incredibly confident, but they also know and feel a passion to constantly improve. Secondly, they feel that not only must they constantly change and improve, but their life, their circumstances, and their results must absolutely also change, and change significantly. They aren't satisfied with things the way they are. They're grateful, and they recognize the goodness in their lives, but they're not satisfied. The passion burns within to matter in a big way, to make a difference in a big way in the few short years they have on Earth. They recognize that their only instrument of success is to constantly improve and master their one instrument of success, their psychology, their physiology, their behaviors, and their actions. Successful people know that they must change if their results are going to change, and they're determined to do so. Next virtue, humility. While humility is not a prerequisite to success, it is to the highly actualized person. Actualized people are confident in their purpose and their mission. They have a clear, compelling vision that burns within them. But at the end of the day, the best of the best, the most actualized, also embody humility. The highly actualized person realizes that they're very fortunate custodians of incredible gifts, intellectual, perceptual, and conditional gifts. They also realize that they are no better than any other decent human being, and each person is equally deserving of respect and consideration. Okay, the next virtue, future-oriented motivation while fully present. Studies of highly successful people show this is one of the few common denominators they all share. It's a future orientation. They have a precise, compelling destination they are committed to reach in 5, 10, 20 or more years. And what they do now, today, is determined by that mission, that person. Today, right now, is rarely, if ever, determined by escape or the illusion of pleasure in video games, internet surfing, drugs, idle conversation, or such things. While they do allow themselves limited downtime, they're on a clear and compelling path of exceptionalism in growth, performance, and results, all culminating at a particular point well in the future. To these people, the supposed fun of hours spent playing video games, watching TV, or surfing the internet is not pleasure. It isn't even mind-numbing escape from life's stressors and problems. To these people, these activities are ultimate intrinsic pain. Okay, the next virtue. Seek and gain a higher level of mastery over our states, therefore our performance. Peak performers understand that the difference between success and failure, greatness and mediocrity, is in large part in how we manage our thoughts, beliefs, and emotions in the moment. Because these things are precursors to the quality and quantity of the action we take. Our habitual thoughts and states determine to a large, if not absolute, degree the nature, quantity, and quality of our habitual actions. They're also, by definition, our actual life experience. If we choose to think, feel, and define current experience as fun, stimulating, rewarding, difference-making, a part of meaningful growth and success, then that is our experience in the moment. That is our life experience. If, however, we choose stories with beliefs and feelings of frustration, anger, boredom, resentment, any number of possible negative states that are unresourceful, then not only will the nature, quality, and duration of our activities, our efforts to succeed suffer, so too will our life experience. That will be our life experience. So the highly actualized and successful person not only chooses productive long-term success-oriented actions in the now, they also choose mental emotional states that are positive, productive, excited, passionate, optimistic, determined, creative, and fun. Any number of positive, productive states. It is consistent, sustained, and effective action that creates our success or lack thereof. And our states determine what we do, how well we do it, and how long and often we do it. All right, the next virtue, self-esteem and self-compassion. Self-esteem is thinking highlier of ourselves, and self-compassion is understanding and accepting our perceived weaknesses, faults, errors, or any unwanted results. These two qualities are, I would argue, necessary to a fully actualized life and person. That said, however, don't confuse self-esteem or self-compassion with either self-efficacy or success. A person can have considerable self-esteem and self-compassion, yet feel little to no drive to grow or succeed. A person can also feel little self-esteem or self-compassion, yet have massive drive to succeed and, in fact, be successful. Self-esteem and self-compassion are important, though, to a healthy, happy, actualized person in life. But they're not necessary to worldly or economic success, although low levels of either can have a negative impact on a person's performance. To me, success without self-esteem and self-compassion is, I believe, a relatively empty vessel, a limited and incomplete life. On the other hand, self-esteem and self-compassion without success in life is fine and preferable to worldly success without self-esteem or self-compassion. However, I prefer all of them. To me, self-esteem and self-compassion and worldly success are all important for a highly actualized, successful life. Okay, the next virtue is bold risk-taking is a must. Reward is commensurate with risk. This is true about most, if not all, things in life, perhaps other than diet and physical health. Think about anything substantial you've done in your life, college, relationships, sports, hobbies, children, work. Every substantial endeavor in life carries risk. There is no potential for pain. There's almost certainly will be little or no potential for gain. It's that simple. Those who play it safe do not accomplish exceptional things in life, and they don't live a full life. Don't get me wrong, there is nothing wrong with this. I in no way demean safe choices or safe people. It's an inherent trait of our brains. It's true, though, that those who gain the most take more risk. Not foolhardy or reckless risk, but risk nevertheless. As they say, the magic only happens when we step outside of our comfort zone. Okay, the next virtue. Ownership of outcome. One of the most valued beliefs of the actualized and successful person is ownership of outcome, personal responsibility for their entire self and life. The highly successful and actualized person understands and embraces that they are wholly responsible for any and all results in their life. Even when circumstances are beyond their control, they own the results. Hey, only we can choose meaning and action that will either forge the metal of our resolve or weaken it. No one else can do this for us. Highly actualized and successful people are so focused on and compelled forward by their mission that any and all circumstances are but temporary blips on the screen of ultimate success. It matters not the source of circumstances. Blame is wasted focus and energy, and action lost to folly. Achieving our mission and purpose, our passion, are all that matters and what drives us forward through any and all circumstances and events. All right, the next virtue. Just let go of the results. This is the flip side of ownership of outcome belief, is the somewhat paradoxical belief that we must let go of attachment to specific results. This doesn't mean that we don't passionately shoot for very specific results, seeing, hearing, and feeling, and tasting the actualization, the creation and manifestation of our specific results, our dreams, our goals, and outcomes. We need that to fuel the fire of intention, behavior, and action. That's absolutely necessary. But once we've made our decisions, we act with full attention, intention, and action in that very specific direction and let go of the results. Because holding on too tightly can cause rigidity, a lack of creativity, and frankly, misery. In fact, it often happens that on our way to our vision, we actually find our destiny. And our destiny might look very different than how we'd imagined it. All right, the next virtue. Contribution. I talk about this all the time. Contributions to others, life. The fullest expression and meaning of our purpose is contribution. We can contribute through virtually any profession and skill set, but it's all about making a difference for others. The primacy of contribution is true from a purely practical perspective. Businesses, products, and services exist to serve others' needs. Contribution is crucial also from a moral ethical perspective. Our highest selves are most served by serving others. All right, so that's it for what I believe are the top virtues and values of highly actualized and successful people. I said sex a few times. Just as we must eat healthy food and exercise virtually each day if we wish to remain in optimal health with clarity of mind and body and longevity, so too with our psychology, our choices, and how we perceive, think, feel, and behave. If we're to remain in optimal health and performance, we must constantly remain self-aware, disciplined, and committed to personal growth and improvement. I encourage you to review these virtues and values on a regular basis. Choose one to focus on, work on for a period of 2 weeks. Actively apply it to the context of you. Ask yourself if you're owning, inhabiting, and personifying the virtue on a consistent, habitual, and high basis. Ask yourself what you will have to believe and do, in fact, to personify them. Please pay it forward. Like, share, and comment on this video. I'll respond to all polite comments and questions. Remember, knowledge is not power. The habitual effective use of knowledge is power. Don't allow this information to become just more useless information you never actually or consistently apply to yourself in your life. I genuinely wish and expect for you the very best, the greatest in self and life. Live, love, and succeed with passion, purpose, and positive personal power, my friends.